GWYNN'S Rockin' Record Reviews. I'm Gwen. I've started the show for a few reasons. There's a lot of awesome older music out there that kids my age don't listen to. I love listening to records because they're awesome and sound great. Parents, there's a lot of bad music out there today. Hook your kids up with a record player and introduce them to some classics. This is a record, and this is a record player, and I'm going to show you how the record works. You just place the record on the record player and hit start. It takes a little more work than an iPod, but it sounds great. The needle just pretty much goes on the record while the record's spinning, and it makes music. Voila, you have music. Today's album is Band on the Run. Band on the Run by Paul McCartney and Wings. Paul McCartney was one of the Beatles, one of the greatest bands of all time. Paul sang and played bass for the Beatles and wrote many of the Beatles' most famous songs, including Yesterday, Hey Jude, and Let It Be. Wings was Paul's second band after the Beatles broke up, but this album was actually recorded without most of the band members. Came out in 1973, over 40 years ago, when my grandparents were in high school. It's a great album, and I think you're really going to enjoy it. Before we get to listening to a few tunes, it's time for Band on the Run Fun Facts!
Fun Facts!
Paul wanted to record this album in a different country, so we went to the African country of Nigeria. Nigeria was a scary place to be in the 70s because of military fighting. Two band members thought it was too scary, so they left the band, which meant Paul had to record many of the instruments by himself. He even got robbed at knife point. Scary stuff. For the album cover, Paul got a bunch of his friends to take pictures, like they were escaping from prison. One of these guys is Christopher Lee, who just recently died at the age of 93. You probably know him as Saruman from Lord of the Rings.
This night, the land will be safe.
Or Count Dooku in Star Wars Episode 2.
My Jedi powers are far beyond yours.
The last song on the album is in memory of painter Pablo Picasso. It's called Picasso's Last Words. Paul wrote this song on the spot when one of his friends, actor Dustin Hoffman, didn't believe he could write a song about just anything. So he asked if he could write one about Picasso's last words, and Paul did it on the spot.
Drink to me, drink to my health. You know I can't drink anymore.
And that's our Band on the Run fun fact. Band on the Run came out at the very end of 1973 and definitely has a rockin' sound to it. The album won 2 Grammy Awards, and Rolling Stone magazine called it the best album of 1974. Overall, most people think it's the best album has ever made after the Beatles. Band on the Run has 10 songs, and all but one of them are really good. Now it's time to start counting down my top 3 favorite songs from Band on the Run. We're gonna start with number 3. Let me roll it. Let's check it out. That rockin' guitar part. So my second favorite song from Band on the Run is the title track and opening song, Band on the Run. Let's give it a listen. how Band on the Run is in three parts, and it's like the coolest song. Before I get to my first favorite song, I'd like to introduce my special guest for this episode.
Hey, I'm back with my special guest, Sydney Zebrants. Sydney, how are you doing today?
I'm good, how are you?
I'm fine. You got a chance to listen to the album Band on the Run today. Did you like it?
Yeah, I loved it. They were very great songs. Wait, are they by the Beatles?
No, they're only by Paul.
Oh, I love Paul so much. Well, they were really great songs. I really liked them a lot.
You also got a chance to listen to the song Bluebird. What did you think of that?
It was amazing. I was devastated by that. It's a mellow song, right?
Yeah,
I like mellow songs, because they make me feel like I'm going to fall asleep and faint.
Well, thanks for coming, Sydney.
You're welcome.
And finally, the moment we've all been waiting for, my favorite song from Band on the Run. Drum roll, please. Jets! Let's give it a listen. Concert. Sing Jet just makes me feel so alive. Well, we're just about out of time for our show today, but I hope you've enjoyed it. I'd love to read your comments. I hope you will subscribe to my channel and keep on watching. Before I go, I want to give a final review of the albums by scoring in four categories: cover art, popularity, originality, and song awesomeness. For each category, I'll give it a score of 1 through 5, and we'll see how this album rates our total of 20 points. Our first category is cover art. I'd give it a 3. It's okay, but kind of plain. The logo looks like the lights really went out. I like the prison theme thing. The people look actually scared. I really like the back cover too. It's pretty cool. The next category is popularity. I'd give it a 5 because no one can argue that this is Paul's most favorite solo album. The next category is originality. I'd give it a 3 because it's a good rock album, but there's nothing super unique about it. Our next category is song awesomeness. I give that a 4. Has some great songs and only one I didn't like. But a couple of songs in this album are all-time favorites for me. The total score was 15 out of 20, making Band on the Run a really good album. Well, that's the end of our show. In the meantime, go grab some records and let's start rocking. I'm Gwyn, and I'll see you next time on